If you are designing a project and you want to consider the shadow parameter as a design parameter, and you want to see the effect of your designs in shadow studies, Revit has great tools for this. Let's go. Hello, this is Javed Hamid, the co-founder of ThoughtView. In this channel, we upload weekly tutorials about Revit, Enscape, and other kind of BIM software. So if you are new, consider subscribing and like this video and share it with your friends and colleagues. It will help us a lot to create more videos like this. Shadows are a great parameter in design process. For example, you have some specific spaces or areas that you want natural lights in them. And also you want to see the exact shadow that will be created in the real world. We have some tools in Revit that we can do some solar studies, and also we can shadow study and take an export from the animations of those days or just one day of our studies. Let's go to the screen share and let me show you how to do that. Okay guys, I'm going to work with this sample project here. But before that, we need to know that some parameters that are that will impress your results. There are some sun settings here, and also we have some other parameters that will impress on our solar studies. For example, when we go to the site plan here, I'm not going to go in details of locations, but when you turn on this reveal hidden item, you will see these two points, project base point and survey points, and also the main parameter that will impress our results is angle to the true north. It will if the project is real, the servers will give you these points and you can set them properly. But for this process, I'm not going to change these numbers here, but I would recommend you, if the project is real 100%, you should do this for your project. And also we have some location parameters that the other parameters will be able to set them from here in sun setting. But let me turn on the sun setting from here, sun path. You have to type here. We are going to work with the first one, and then we are going to the sun setting, and here we can choose many options. The most important parameter is the location, that you can change it from here. You have some options here. You can use the default city list from here, for example, which city you are going to use, and also the servers will give you latitude and longitude. These are some important angles that you can specify these with your location. This option is more accurate, but you should have these two parameters from your servers. But if you are doing a conceptual analysis and it's not really a detailed analysis, you can use from the other option here from internet mapping service, and you can search the place you want, or you can press the coordinates here with this format or any other kind of formats. You need to press a comma between them, but I'm going to specify the place by myself. For example, here I'm going to put this home icon here. Okay, it is great, and then you can see the project address too. But before that, you could set this two parameter manually. Okay, it is great, and click on OK, and the position of sun will and angle of sun will change. The next option is your date. For example, there is any difference between the, for example, May sun with other months' sun, or in comparison together. So, for example, I'm going to have these four. Maybe I would change the year to 2021, and for July and 12th of July. Okay, it is great, and also I'm going to put the time. But we are going to take analyze this sun for a month, not just one day. If you want to see the exact sun in just one day and 1 hour in that minute, you can use the still. But sun analysis for an entire day, you need to use single day. But if you want to use from multi day, for example, I'm going to see the sun analysis from the 1st of July to the end of July. So I'm going to use multi day from here. I specified the location, and for the dates we have 2 days. For example, from the 1st to the end of July. Okay. And I'm just going to see the sunrise to sunset. I'm not going to see the all of the day, because when it is night, it's not going to work for me. So sunrise to sunset, and for the time interval, I'm going to see 1 hour. Okay, it is great, and we can save settings here for July, and also you can get some alternatives. For example, if you would put this building in one area of your city, and you can compare it with this building in another area. So alternative one would be the name, and it is great, and click OK. Okay, you will see this, but it's not going to work for me. I'm going to go to the file menu. Let me put it on maybe hidden line. Okay, now you can see the shadows better. And then you need to go to the file menu, and from here, go to the export, scroll down, and image and animation, click on solar study, and you can use all frames, okay, and frame per second, maybe 30 frame would be great. And also for the time, can maybe make it bigger. Or we can put it on all frame, and also if you would make it less, you will see more times. For example, 2 frame per second would be great for this, because I'm going to see the exact shadows for each day. And also I'm going to put it on hidden line. You can use it with shaded, realistic, and other kind of that, but I'm going to put on hidden line. It's going to be 1920 in 1080. Okay, it is great, and click on OK, and you can say that. Before that, let me create a crop region here, because it will specify the areas that you want to render. It will help you a lot, so make sure you're creating one of them. Okay, this is great. Let's go to the file menu again, to the export, and to the solar study exports again, and let me change the settings again. It is great, and click on okay, and I specify the place. I'm going to save it to the desktop, maybe alt one. This is great, and click on save. You need to wait a little bit. Maybe let me put it on full frame on compress, or take a speed. It's not really make difference here. Let me put it on compress, and click on OK, and you need to wait a little bit and you will have the results. Okay, now we have the right results. Let's check them. And also we have the timestamps too, which is great. And it is better now. Let me open this and you can see the time. And you can see the frames here and also the dates. For example, you will stop here and this is the sun in this time, in this date, in this specific location and sun angle. But the tip here, if you want to see the inside the building, you can create some sections here and also you can place a camera. Let me place a camera in entry level. Let me place a camera here. Let me place this camera, for example, here. And now, for example, if you want to see the effect of shadows in this area, you can now go to the file menu in export and go to the image as an animation again. But now you can see you don't have the solar study here. So you need to create some sections for it. For example, you would, you can create some sections. For example, let me place the unhide the section box. And let me create a section for this floor plan. Let me adjust the section. And now you can have this kind of views too. For example, let me make it a little bit smaller. And let me zoom. And now you can see, you can create some kind of views like this. I'm going to assign the exact parameters again and create a solar study for this. Okay, now see the results in this one and we will wrap this video. Okay, you can see now you can see the exact spaces in more details.